Hi guys, welcome back to another DIY video. So this time around, I am updating our guest bathroom once again. This is what it looks like before. I always wanted to have this tile out, but instead I literally just took a Sharpie and did a herringbone pattern just to have something up on the wall. That was the old amateur me, but it's time to dress it up. And this is what the bathroom looks like today with legit subway tiles. This is my first time tiling anything ever. I watched a couple of YouTube videos, did a little bit of research, and I went for it. I wanted to redo this wall because this is a guest bathroom, meaning guests will come over and use this bathroom, and they're totally gonna judge the house based on this bathroom, so this shit gotta look good. I got a quote for $1,200 for just labor. I said no thank you, fuck it, this is the perfect wall to experiment tiling on. It's small, it's not going to get wet, I'm up for the challenge. My costs, including the tiles and buying a tile saw and all the tools I needed for this project, came out to about $300. Before tiling, I ran a straight edge throughout the wall and found out that it's a little bowed in, and it got me a little nervous, but I just went for it thinking if I run into problems later on, I'll just deal with it. My reassurance was that I'll make sure to use a leveler every two or three rolls. To start, I removed the standard mirror that came with the house. It was held on by glue. I gently pry the mirror off the wall with my fingers. Usually, you would start at the bottom, but because I want the tiles to be aligned with the sink and because I want to hang a mirror in the middle of the sink, I had to start my first line in the middle of the wall. And to do that, I use a straight edge piece of wood as a ledge to carry out my tiles for the first row. I mounted it flush with the quartz piece of the sink. The toilet is in the way, so I had planned to remove the toilet. Then I realized I didn't need to remove the toilet. It was easier to just remove the tank. I stopped the water, flush, unscrew the water line connected to the tank, unscrew two bolts, and was able to remove the tank. If I were to remove the toilet, I would have to reset the toilet. It really means that I would just need to remove the wax ring and put on a new wax ring. However, I'm glad I didn't have to. For this project, I bought the AcroPro 1-gallon ceramic tile adhesive that is already made. I didn't want to mix anything at all. This is perfect because all you do is open the container, scoop it up like ice cream, and spread away. I used a 1/4 inch trowel for the 2x8 tiles that I chose, took a scoop of the tile adhesive, smeared it all over the wall, just enough for two rows of tiles. The goal is to get the adhesive onto the wall, then using the trowel notch side, running across to create what I call the lines. Then I laid my first row of tiles, making sure it sits flat with the bottom. This first row is important because it will set the standard for the rest of the upper rows, so I want to make sure it's leveled. I find it easier to lay the tiles in a row than going back to put the spacers. For this project, I use one of the 16 spacers. Once I got to the corner where I need to make a cut, I used the Ryobi tile saw that I got from Home Depot for $130. Super easy to use, super easy to cut with. Now that I have the measurement for the end piece, I went ahead and cut a couple pieces because this row will be repeated every other row. When laying down the tiles, I apply medium pressure enough to where I feel the tiles are sticking to the wall. I always worry about unevenness when all the tiles are up, but like I said, I made sure everything is level after two or three rows. And it's also important that the wall is flat. It doesn't have to be perfect. For example, I didn't patch up my wall after I took off the mirror, but it was still workable enough where it won't affect the tiles. Once the top half is done and my first couple of bottom rows are dried, I remove my straight edge to start working on the bottom half. This part's a little tricky because I am now starting from the top. I have no ledge for the tiles to rest on, so I had to work fast to reach the bottom row, going back after each row to make sure the tiles don't sag. I worked quickly to get to the last row before the adhesive dried. Once all the tiles are up, I stepped back and was kind of amazed with myself that I did this, that I got all the fucking tiles to stick to the walls. Like, who am I? If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It helps rank this video and also promote growth for my channel, and I greatly appreciate it. Anyways, I waited until the following day to grout. Before grouting, I used painter's tapes to tape up my surrounding edges. It helps later on to get a clean grout line in the corners. I bought the Poly Blend brand with a light gray color. Also going with a non-sanded grout because my joints are pretty small. I pour my grout into a bucket, leaving some leftovers just in case I need to touch up another day. I added water following the instructions on the box. I attached the mixer to my drill, then mix away. Then I realized I needed to add more water until I get to that paste consistency that my common sense told me I needed, rather than going with what the direction on the box says. Once I have the grout mix, I know I have about 40 minutes to grout before it dries up, and the time is based on the temperature and the environment of the workspace. It can dry faster, it can dry slower, humidity is also a factor. You're just going to have to gauge it, but for my situation, I know my ass gotta grout quickly before it dries up. The goal of grouting is really to get the grout in the joints. Starting from the top, I spread the grout at a 45 degree angle going down. Then to remove the excess, I pull my grout float downwards at a 90 degree angle. After getting the grout into the joints, the tiles are going to be messy. It's okay. This is where the tile sponge comes in. Soak the sponge in water, squeeze out all the water, then just wipe away. Soak the sponge again when it feels like it picked up a good amount of grout, then squeeze the water and repeat. The more you clean, the more the tiles will get its shine back. Just make sure you don't pick up too much grout from the joints. After a couple rounds of cleaning the grout off the tiles, I waited about 20 minutes for the grout to dry. Then I used a damp microfiber towel to wipe off in the haze to really remove any excess grout on the tiles. Repeat a couple of times and let it dry. I didn't tile all the way to the top. There's about an inch gap from the wall because my ceiling is not completely straight. It actually slopes down a little bit towards the right. So what I did was add a trim piece up top to hide that imperfection. What I've learned from this project is that it's not hard, it's just labor intensive. My ass was reaching for like hours. It just felt like I was doing some hardcore yoga for a long time. It probably would have been easier if I didn't have the vanity sink and the toilet in the way. To finish off this wall, I hung a round corner mirror above the sink. I went with the brass trim to add some color to the space. I also chose a mid-century modern brass pendant to go with the mirror. This is my first time tiling and it turned out better than I expected. I hope this video gives you some motivation to start whatever project you've been putting off. I always say, if I can do it, you can do it. It's really just a matter of if you're willing to or not. I'm not smarter than anyone. I'm not a professional contractor. What I do have is drive. So if I see something that I'm willing to try, I'll go for it. Once, maybe twice. All right, guys, thanks for sticking with me through this video. Hit the like button if you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments below. And until the next time.